Hi, welcome to Sylvan Heights Bird Park. My name is Zeek, and I'm an aviculturist here, and today we're going to be talking about spoonbills. Spoonbills can be found on all 6 inhabited continents worldwide, but rosette spoonbills like this one are the only ones that are pink. Similar to flamingos and ibis, they'll get that pink coloration from the foods that they eat, and they'll get more vibrant pink as they get older. This one behind me is about a year old. They'll lay their eggs once they're 3 to 4 years old, sometimes even older, and it'll take them about a month to hatch out, then another month before they're old enough to start leaving the nest, and then another 2 to 4 weeks before they're fully ready to fly. Roseate spoonbills can be found as far south as Chile and Argentina, and as far north as Texas and Florida, although they'll occasionally make it all the way up right here into North Carolina. Spoonbills love wetland habitats, and can often be found in sort of coastal estuary-type spaces, which are super important habitats for spoonbills and also for people. They can minimize the damage from storms such as hurricanes and tsunamis. So protecting the wetland habitats is super important for us, and it's super important for the spoonbills that breed there, right? There you go. Here at Sylvan Heights, we'll hand-rear some of our birds for any number of reasons. This spoonbill, for example, is one that we hand-reared. Hand-rearing the birds makes them more engaging with the general public whenever you come to visit the facility. So next time you're at Sylvan Heights walking through the South America aviary, keep an eye out for this spoonbill and our other spoonbills that we have around. Spoonbills get their name from their bill, shaped like a spoon, and if you get a look at this one right here, you can see that he's got a hole in the end of his bill. That was an injury that he had as he was a young bird, and we've kept a close eye on it over the course of the years, and while it hasn't fully healed up and fixed that hole, it's not causing him any pain or issues, and as you can see, he eats just fine. Spoonbills will eat fish, small crustaceans, any number of things found in wetland habitats, and they do that by sweeping their bill from side to side through the water. Thanks so much for joining us to learn about spoonbills today. You can come to Sylvan Heights Tuesday through Sunday. We're open 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. For more information about Sylvan Heights, you can check out our website at shwpark.com or follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.